When you reach the plantation, they put irons to the fire. And do this. To let you know that you no longer belong to God, but to a man.
Mr. Wilberforce, we understand you're having problems choosing whether to do the work of God or the work of a political activist.
We humbly suggest that you can do both.
Like me. Are you contemplating a life of solitude?
People like you too much. Besides,
Wilbur, you have work to do. Blind, but
now I once was blind, but now I see.
Did I write that?
Yes, you did.
Now at last it's true.
Amazing Grace.
I praise God for some of the good, positive Christian films that have been coming out recently, such as Amazing Grace in 2007 for the 200th anniversary of the abolition of the slave trade. And this film focusing on part of the incredible diverse life, and this could only scratch the surface of this phenomenally fascinating character of William Wilberforce. He was God's politician. He was a missionary to Parliament. William Wilberforce was a man who dealt with so many things. He's most famous because he spent his whole life, dedicated his entire career in Parliament to ending the slave trade and then ending slavery itself and setting all the captives free. He did a lot more than that too. He helped found the British and Foreign Bible Society. He founded the Royal Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals. That's one very inaccurate part of the film. The film starts with him stopping his cart to basically chastise a man for mistreating and beating his horse, but it has him far too calm. He never tolerated cruelty to animals, and while the film is right to show him stopping to rebuke the man, he wouldn't have done it in as restrained a manner as was depicted in the film. In fact, the grandson of William Wilberforce gave testimony to how he never saw his father more furious and angry than when he saw cruelty to animals as depicted in the film, and the very mild rebuke that he gave to that person isn't in keeping with the entire character of William Wilberforce. So it's a pity the film started with such a misstep of just failing to appreciate just how intently he opposed evil and cruelty and injustice on every level. It rose to the occasion on the slave trade, but it was far too weak in terms of how he felt about cruelty to animals. Nevertheless, praise God that this film is drawing our attention to William Wilberforce. William Wilberforce is an inspiration to Christians because right from the beginning, he saw that God had placed him in Parliament for the good of his kingdom and to love his neighbor and to apply the Lordship of Christ to all areas of life. And those people who today may feel tired and wearied in the pro-life fight, we've been fighting for years, we don't seem to be getting very far. If they would look at William Wilberforce, he had far greater obstacles, far more discouragement, far more opposition. And the man persevered for far longer, and yet with results that echo for eternity, and millions of captives were set free, and what he did is an inspiration and example to us all. I think for anybody who's in the political, socio-political fight, or fighting for the right to life of the pre-born, or fighting against pornography or human trafficking or any of these evils, if they need encouragement, I'd say go and read the biographies of men like William Wilberforce and see that film Amazing Grace again, and I think it will energize us all to realize we mustn't give up the fight. We are not called to be short distance sprinters. We're called to be long distance marathon runners. We've got a long road to run, and we mustn't get discouraged if we don't get immediate results, because we are working for eternity and we are serving a God who is sovereign, and we need to keep our focus and not allow ourselves to get discouraged or distracted or defeated or deviated. We've got to stay the course.